Now, on which frequency the satellite is going to be operated? So most of the satellites works in the super high frequency range, but with a different frequency band. So what are the different frequency band? The frequency bands are N, S, C, X, K, and K. Alright, why these namings are there? To identify the range of frequency. Okay, how? For L band, the frequency is 1 to 2 GHz. For S band, the frequency is 2 to 4. For C band, 4 to 8. X band, 8 to 12. K band, 12 to 18. K band, 18 to 28. And the last one, K band, has 28 to 40 GHz. So these are the microwave frequency band. So out of this frequency band, we are going to use the two band for the satellite communication. That is earlier it was used, that is a C band. Nowadays ISRO is working on the Ku band and Ka band. So for satellite communication, we are going to use Ku band and the nowadays Ka band. Got it? Now, what are the advantages? The advantages are, first, for satellite communication, it allows point to multi-point communication. How? We know that for microwave communication, it requires a line of sight, that means point to point communication. Your transmitter and receiver should be in one line. So it is known as line of sight. So to overcome the disadvantage of this, we are going to implement the satellite which allows point to multipoint. The best example is broadcasting. That means the transmitter is one and receivers are multiple. Alright? So we can say that it allows a point to multipoint communication. Second, the circuit for satellite can be installed rapidly, as the satellite is in specific position, the earth station can be installed and communication can be established within few hours or within some days. Alright? Third, if we want to relocate the earth station because of such a critical condition, we can reinstall and we can also establish a communication relatively in few amount of time. Fourth one, the mobile communication can be easily achieved by this satellite communication because of its flexibility. So the last advantage is, as compared to fiber optic cable, we know that the different advantages and the disadvantage of optical communication in the last semester. So to overcome that disadvantage, we are going to implement the communication with the help of satellite. So compared to the fiber optic cable, satellite communication has the advantage of quality of transmitting signal. How? We know that in cable, there are different types of loss, as we are going to use a fiber optic cable. Alright, so to improve the quality of transmitting signal, we are going to use the satellite communication, because in cable, as the signal is moving and if it covers a longer distance, that signal is going to be degraded or signal is going to be attenuated. But with the help of the satellite communication, we are able to transmit a signal to a thousands of kilometers with improving quality of transmitting signal. Alright, so these are the advantages of satellite communication. As it has advantages, it has also disadvantages. So what are the disadvantages? First, with the satellite in position, the communication path between a terrestrial transmitter and receiver, it is approximately having a distance of 75,000 kilometers. So we can say that it produces a delay between transmission and the reception of signal. Why? Because the velocity of electromagnetic wave is 3×10⁸ meter per second. So based on that, there is a 1/4 second of delay between transmission and the reception of signal, right? So this time delay, what is the effect of this time delay? This time delay will going to reduce the efficiency of satellite in terms of data transmission, in terms of a transmission of long file, which is going to be carried out by a satellite. Alright, so these are the disadvantages of satellite. Now, what is orbit? As I have told you, a satellite is moving around the earth in specific path. So that specific path is known as the orbit. So technically, the definition of orbit is, it is a path in which satellite goes around the earth is called orbit. You can see from over here, this image shows this yellow line is called the orbit on which a satellite is moving around the earth. Alright, it has a certain distance. So based on the distance from the surface of the earth, that orbit is going to be classified. The classifications are LEO, MEO, GEO and HEO. LEO stands for low earth orbit, MEO stands for medium earth orbit, GEO stands for geostationary orbit, and the fourth one, it is highly elliptical orbit. Alright, now we will see these types of orbit based on the location from the surface of the earth. Alright, you can see that the LEO is nearest to the surface of the earth, that means a distance from the earth to the LEO is lowest, that's why it is called low earth orbit. Second one, a medium earth orbit, that means it has a medium distance. The distance is 5000 to 10000 km for MEO from the surface of the earth. GEO stands for geostationary orbit. It has the highest approximated distance, around 36,000 km, which lies on the equator of the earth. And the last one, that is HEO, that is highly elliptical orbit. As its name suggests, highly elliptical, the shape of the orbit is in the elliptical form, so it creates a 2 point. One is the farthest from surface of the earth and another one is the nearest to the surface of the earth. Then what that point is known as, it is called apogee and the perigee respectively, that we will discuss into the chapter number 2, right? So this is the types of orbit based on the distance from the surface of the earth. So LEO has distance of 100 to 1500 km, MEO has 5000 to 10000, GEO has 36,000 and HEO has approximately around 25,000 km. So, based on the types of orbit like LEO, MEO, GEO and HEO, we can say that the application of this orbit. So, this LEO is used for communication and the remote sensing purpose. We can say that it can be used as the International Space Station. Second, the medium Earth orbit. So this satellite in this orbit is commonly used for the navigational system, including a US GPS system. Alright. Third, geosynchronous or geostationary. As its name suggests, geostationary. What does it mean? The meaning is, a geostationary orbit means the rotational speed of the Earth and the satellite is same. So, at each and every point onto the Earth, my satellite is seems to be a stationary. Why? Because the rotational speed of satellite is same as the rotational speed of the Earth. Alright, and as this geostationary satellite lies on the equator of the Earth, that's why we can say that from the ground's perspective, a geo objects which lies on the Earth's equator, they appear to be in the fixed position. Alright, so this GEO and GSO are used for the Earth observation and the telecommunication purpose. Right, last one, the fourth, the highly elliptical orbit. So, in HEO, as I have told you, it has a one point which is near to the surface of the Earth and the other point which is having a more distance. That's why this HEO are more suitable for communication and the remote sensing purpose. So, in today's session, we have seen the satellite, history of satellite, types of satellite, how it works, frequency band, what is orbit, and what are the types of orbit. So, over here, in number one of satellite communication is phase. But still, if you have any doubt, well, ask me on my email ID, which is mentioned over here. Till then, thank you for your attention.